With the pandemic raging and his last electoral chances dead or dying, the outgoing president of the United States is still refusing to accept the... You know what? It doesn't matter. I was about to start off tonight telling you about you-know-who and what outrage he's done today, not accepting the results, blah, 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 claiming fraud here. It doesn't matter. It's done. He's done. He's the past. Joe Biden, for better or worse, is the present and the future. He's the president-elect. So let's start tonight by talking about him. Today, CNN and other news outlets projected that when the recount is over, President-elect Biden will be the winner in Georgia, giving him 306 electoral votes, the exact same number as the current person in the White House got in 2016, which he called a landslide back then. No sign the hand recount, which got started today in Georgia, will alter the outcome when it wraps up. It's said to be going smoothly on a bipartisan basis, despite Georgia's Secretary of State now under COVID quarantine. In Arizona, the Trump campaign was forced to drop a legal challenge when President-elect Biden's lead became insurmountable. In Michigan, a judge refused to block the certification of results in Detroit and debunked several allegations of fraud by poll watchers there. In Pennsylvania, the law firm attempting to block President-elect Biden's win there withdrew from the case. On top of that, the Washington Post is reporting that federal prosecutors specifically assigned by the Justice Department to monitor election malfeasance, have written a letter to their boss, Attorney General Barr, telling him they have found no evidence of substantial irregularities. That's what happened today. That is what matters. Now, of course, look, President Trump is still president, and his spokespeople are still out there trying to keep their boss from turning on them. But there's no point in getting all riled up about it. It doesn't matter. Take a look at this, but it doesn't matter.
Are you prepared to say that the president will, President Trump will definitely attend the inauguration?
I think the president will attend his own inauguration. He would have to be there, in fact.
You really think you can turn this around?
Absolutely.
What she says absolutely doesn't matter. It just doesn't. I mean, we could go into all the reason the current occupant of the White House isn't conceding. He doesn't want to be out of the spotlight. He doesn't want to admit defeat. It's not how he was raised by his stern father. Please, it doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter. There is a lot that does still matter, however, and I want to talk about that. Tonight, the country recorded more new coronavirus infections than any other day, ever. There are people right now in crowded ICUs all across the country. Some ICUs don't have any more beds. There's people in ICUs right now, tonight, fighting for their lives, fighting for each painful breath that they can get. People who should not be there because we should have worn masks more. All of us, myself included. We should have social distanced more. We should have had leaders who took this seriously in the White House. This is what matters now. There's a kid at home right now, scared to death because his dad is in the hospital and he doesn't know if he will ever get to see him again. Do you know what that feels like? We didn't do enough. Take a look at this graph. That's where we are right now. We are on a line heading straight up nearly straight up. I cannot spend another second today concerned about what a grown man who lost fair and square isn't ready to accept. I'm not ready to accept that there could be 400,000 dead Americans by the 1st of February. Doesn't matter that I can't accept it. Doesn't matter what I think, what I can't accept. That's the reality if we don't do better. More than 160,000 new cases today. 1,306 reported fatalities. 1,306 human beings, our fellow countrymen and women, dead. More will die in this hour and in the next hours to come. Illinois today hit another record, more than 15,000 new cases and a record number of people in the hospital. Record hospitalization numbers for the country as well. In northwestern Wisconsin, the Mayo Clinic says its hospitals are full, not just the ICUs, all beds full. The CEO of another area hospital chain had this grim update.
It's well above what we can tolerate right now and still save lives. And I don't know why it's continuing to get worse. From a healthcare standpoint, we're tapped out. Our beds are getting full every day. Nurses are exhausted, physicians are exhausted, we're exhausted.
The president spoke about COVID today in the Rose Garden, and thank goodness at least he finally said something about it. He praised the new vaccine that we've been talking about all week, and by all indications, it is good news. As for what hospitals and medical professionals and grieving families are up against, the president had little to say, not that it matters. Seems most people stopped looking to him for comfort or empathy a long, long time ago. Of course, he lied about testing and praised his leadership, blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to go into the details of his lies. They don't matter anymore. He's leaving. He's the past. Of course, he used the opportunity to threaten all the citizens of New York by withholding the initial doses of the vaccine, blaming New York's governor, and we'll talk to the governor tonight. And that would matter if he actually did that. And because he always ends up doing what he falsely accuses others of, he barely even mentioned the current surge and said nothing about how to address it. Just a few weeks ago, not that it matters, this is precisely what he said Joe Biden would be doing by now.
That's all I hear about now. That's all I hear. Turn on television. Right? COVID, 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 COVID. A plane goes down. 500 people dead. They don't talk about it. COVID, 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 COVID. By the way, on November 4th, you won't hear about it anymore.
Well, you will hear about it because you must hear about it. While I sit here tonight, not even thinking about how many breaths I'm taking, there are thousands and thousands of people gasping for breath. And we must hear them. We must do what we can to help them. Keeping them honest, this thing the president said no one would be talking about anymore is the Biden team's stated first priority. Now, can they deliver? I don't know. And if they lie and they twist the truth and make mistakes like this past administration, we will report as diligently and aggressively about that as we have about this president's failures and lies. But at least the president-elect is talking about COVID and has been all along. That matters. Wearing a mask matters. The president is doing everything he can to sabotage their efforts, of course. And sadly, that is one thing the president is doing that really does matter right now.